Of course, the other big question everybody would want to ask, especially the cynics, does the world really need a nano? Harsh Usman tries to find out.
The Wonder Car was greeted with a mix of hysteria and aspiration across the nation. But does that automatically translate into commercial success?
This is going to be, you know, low cost, low margin car, and therefore volumes become important. You know, demand is really going to depend on how much bookings. It's going to depend on the domestic market and the export market, because they're planning to export it as well.
A mix of timing and pricing could actually end up playing spoiler for the Nano. Consider this: Indian car buyers increasingly prefer more feature-rich cars. The sales of the Maruti 800, the Nano's closest competitor, actually declined last year, while the Alto outsold it by a fair margin. So the question is, will the Nano appeal to the upwardly mobile, especially with second-hand car prices almost at par? So the Nano might be the preserve of first-time car buyers. But still, the industry does not see it eating too much into the two-wheeler pie, despite mass bikes ranging in the 40 to 60,000 rupee price band.
The sticker price is not the only thing that determines whether somebody switches from a two-wheeler to a four-wheeler. It's the overall operating cost, and there's a very clear step jump between them. I think the Nano is going to create its own segment.
But the Nano does hold one key advantage over two-wheelers. Financing is available for the Nano at an attractive 12%, while for two-wheelers, the rates are almost double.
So does the world need a Nano? The loudest no will probably come from environmentalists already troubled by an increasing number of vehicles on the road. If you ask me, I'd say yes, but only after they make this road to my office wider so that traffic jams don't get worse. In New Delhi, Harsh Usman for NDTV Profit.